This is your inspirational wake-up call, and you are inside the house with Professor Shire. And we are coming to you from the Caribbean. To be exact, from downtown Port of Spain in Trinidad and Tobago. Welcome to episode 38. Do you know, faith is trusting in something you cannot explicitly prove? Oh yeah. A big shout out to my global friends and family. Today, we'll be looking at faith and its importance in our lives. So please, stay with me. So I've looked at the definition of faith, and it speaks to complete trust or confidence in someone or something. Strong belief in the doctrines of a religion based on spiritual conviction rather than proof. Faith, derived from the Latin word fides, or the old French word fade, meaning is confidence or trust in person, thing, or concept. In the context of religion, one can define faith as belief in God or in the doctrines or teachings of religion. Now, faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen. Stay with me. Today, I'm extremely humbled by these findings as they suggest that we were all taught to have faith in someone, something, or a concept. You know, faith seems to be the first step in understanding this great mystery of our universe and the master plan behind all of this. However, wanting to look at faith from the perspective as a tool to be used before we come to the consciousness of knowingness, let us reflect on what brought us where we are today. First, we were born and know that one day we will die. We accepted that without experiencing birth ourselves and even dying. However, over the years we have witnessed these things happening and we have accepted them as facts. Now, let's examine the things we were told to trust and have faith in. We were told that we are more than the physical body. Do we trust that? Do we have faith in that? We were also told that we will live forever in the heavenly worlds depending on how we live here. Do we trust that? Or do we have faith in that? We were also told that we were made in the image and likeness of God, which in my mind is soul. Do we trust that? Or do we have faith in that? So it means we must go with a belief system until we can prove these concepts. I will continue this subject, but before I go, let me leave you with this. God is what we believe it is. No man is wrong about the existence of God, and yet no man is right about the knowledge of God. There is no mystery of God except that it is what each soul believes that it is. Taken from Stranger by the River by Paul Twitchell. Until next time, let us keep loving our hearts. Let us hold each other's hands to make it through these times. This was your inspirational wake-up call with Professor Shire. Love you all.